My name is Su Fujimoto from Tokyo, and I'm an architect. Nature and architecture is really a fundamental theme, and how to do with these opposite things. It's not just an opposite, but I like to find something, yeah, in a sense, in between. So that is the starting point. And then, not only nature and architecture, but for example, inside, outside, or urban scales, every kind of a definition has such an in-between space. Especially if the definition is the opposite side, then the in-between space is more, how to say, rich. Good example is the Serpentine Pavilion, just finished in London. And it is, in a sense, it's in a various meaning, it is kind of in-between things. It is made by grid, but the shape is very soft and complex. So the experience is half nature, like a tree branches, and half, of course, super artificial things that are integrated together. And I was talking about the final wooden house. It's made by the huge wooden block. And in that case, kind of a beautiful integration of the architectural elements in a various different levels. For example, the wooden blocks could be the floors or furniture or the walls. So in that house, every definitions are melting together to create just a feel for life. I also show the private house in Tokyo. It's a many different levels. It is not like a house, but more like a soft territory, something beyond the independent house, I think. The client is a young couple, and they are really enjoying the life in that house. And it's a really surprising collaboration between the client and the architects. The concept of the creating something in between is not only for the specific a smaller scale private house, but I am thinking it could be developed more, how to say, for example, skyscraper scales or urban scales, because in any case, the definitions, for example, the high-rise building, skyscrapers, and the landscapings, it's opposite. But then we can find something between skyscrapers and the landscaping, and it could be a nice challenge. So I like to expand such a the way of thinking is more and more to explore the such a pioneering or the hidden place of the architectural field. Not just how to say superficial elegant, but more based on our really primitive activities, behaviors. It is a library for the art university, and our concept is the forest of books. It means, of course, the library is a really functional place where you will find books, where you will study or you will do the researches. But at the same time, I thought the library is the place where you can freely walk around looking for inspirations or
for no purpose. It's like a spiral. And it has the openings. So this bookshelf wall has many openings. So you can see through these layers. Sometimes you can see through almost all the layers and sometimes see through it. So every time, and of course walk through it. So every time you, for example, around here, you will see many, many layers on the bookshelves. You will get some inspirations, you will encounter with unexpected books, or such kind of amazing experience could happen. The experience walking around in the library is half like a natural forest, but half like walking in the Tokyo small pathway. So for me, it's really calm, quiet library, but at the same time, it is really active and dynamic, like a Tokyo city situation. You start to walk around. It's like an almost infinite continuation of the walking process. But then sometimes, you will feel this corner could be the comfortable place to have a rest, and then to sit down and take a book from the bookshelf of the around here. The geometry itself is quite really pure, strong spiral shape, but your behaviors is quite diverse and amazing, almost like walking in the infinite labyrinth.